Hello friends, we are going to learn set theoretical approach. Set theoretical approach to probability. Right. In probability, we do experiment, right? Here, an experiment is done through a rectangle, is it right? All the events occurring will be under this, and this is known as space, is it right? Now, event, see, what is an experiment? Experiment is tossing a coin. So, which are the two events in an experiment? One is add, number two is take. Now, the events in an experiment are denoted by a circle. Say this circle and this circle. This should be of same side, size. This should be head and this will be tail. And by this approach, we will be solving some of the problems of probability. Let us say these two events are mutually exclusive events. So what is mutually exclusive events? Way A intersection B is equal to 0. So they don't intersect, they don't happen together. Is it all? Now let us learn about intersection event. So there is one experiment where there are two events. This is event A, and let me change the color, and say this is event. Can you tell me about something about this portion? This is when A and B is occurring or happening simultaneously. This portion, this blue color portion, is treated as A intersection B. Is it all right? It is A and B happening simultaneously. This is intersection. Let us learn something about union. Now, what is union? Try to understand. So, this is an experiment, and this are two events, A and B. Can you tell me something about this portion? This is A and B. No, sometimes only A is happening, sometimes only B is happening, sometimes both A and B is happening. Now understand once again. Sometimes only A is happening, sometimes only B is happening, sometimes A and B is happening. I hope you understand it is different from this. Is it alright? A intersection B. Is it alright? Here in A intersection B, what is happening? A and B both are happening. Here only A, only B, or A and B, this are happening. Is it all right? So, in short, this three line in probability is termed in this manner: A or B is happening. So when A is happening, there A is also happening, or B is happening, and in Venn diagram language, this is known as A intersection B. No, this is termed as A union B. Is it all right? So this area will be termed as A union B. How to find out A intersection B numerically, A union B numerically, that will be understanding in next lecture. We are going to learn something about A union B. So let us divide it into two parts. First part is, if event are mutually exclusive. Try to understand, I am drawing only two events and these events are mutually exclusive. A, B. This is event A, this is event B, this is sample space. Why they are mutually exclusive? Because A intersection B is null set, or there is no A intersection B. Is it all right? In this case, I want to find out A union B. Let me revise once again how to find out a probability of A union B and what is this. Is it all right? A union B is either A happens or B happens, or A and B happens. Here this is not possible. Why? There is no intersection. A intersection B is equal to null set. Is it all right? So is equal to So here A and B is not possible, but how to find out probability of A union B? Is it right? That is a probability of getting head, or probability of getting A, plus probability of getting B. Now I told you, when it is or, either A or B happens, we always use the sign plus. Is it all right? Why it is so, I tell you. Suppose this experiment is tossing a coin. A is getting an head and B is getting a tail. Is it all right? Then, what is the probability of getting head? Is 0.50, that we know. What is probability of getting tail? Is also 0.50. What is the total probability? What? Now think logically. What is P A union B? Either head comes or tail comes. What are the chances that either head or tail will come? Think logically, it is certainty, there is no probability, there is certainty that either head or tail will happen. What are the percentage? 1 into 100 is 100%. Is this answer correct? The answer is yes. Is it alright? Had we done PA into B, 0.50 into 0.50, the answer would be 0.25, which is a correct answer, not a correct answer, it is a not a correct answer. Is it alright? Are you all getting it? So ultimately, what's to be done is, if it is A union B or A or B, whenever there is or, which sign will be used? A positive sign will be used. Yes, of course, this is for only mutually exclusive event, and this is PA plus PB. Now thus, in this case, let me also explain you one more thing. Exhaustive events. What are exhaustive events? When PA union B is equal to 1, the events are known as exhaustive events. As the answer was 1, try to understand what is over here. Nothing. There are only two events. Which two events? A and B. That is A. Here it is B. Is it? So there is nothing except A and B. So this type of events are also this event. Tossing a coin, getting head or tail are exhaustive events. Is it? So simple formula, if PA union B will be is equal to PA plus PB. Is it? If there are three, PA union B union C. If there are three events, it will be PA plus PB plus PC. Sorry. This will be nothing but a probability if the events are mutually exclusive events. Second, if events are not a mutually exclusive event, if events are not mutually exclusive, then what is to be done? If the events are not mutually exclusive events, then we need to find out PA union B. How to find out PA union B in that case? Let me first draw a diagram where the events are not mutually exclusive. Sorry. This is a set A. This is a set B. Is there an intersection? Yes. Are they mutually exclusive event? The answer is no. Is it alright? How to find out in this case? Is it, right? It is simple. What is the logical idea of PA union B in this case? Is either A happens or B happens or PA, that is A and B happens. Is it alright? So these are all the possibilities of PA union B. Is it alright? Then, how to find out the answer? Is it a PA, probability of getting A. Is it all right? Alright, now, let me take another color of getting and A. This is probability of getting A, this blue color. Is it all right? This is probability of getting A. What is the probability of getting B? This is probability of getting B, including this area. So plus P B, and I have got this diagram of PA union B. But the problem is this portion, exactly this portion is P A intersection B. Is it all right? This portion is included in PA also. This portion is included in PB also. So it is included two times. Should it be included one time? The answer is yes. But it should not be included two times. If it is included two times, I'll be removing one time and will be getting an answer of PA union B. PA, this area, PB, this area, minus PA intersection B, because this area was included two times, so it will be ultimately, this will be the formula when the events are not mutually exclusive, is it all? Now, if the answer is PA union B union C, if this is an idea, PA union B union C, is it all? Then the formula will go like this: PA plus PB plus PC minus PA intersection B minus PB intersection C minus PA intersection C. Now, why this is deducted, we already know. We have understood this logic, is it alright? But if you draw a Venn diagram, having three sets A, B and C, you have removed once this area and this area. Why it is removed, we have understood it over here. But if you exactly concentrate on this area, exactly on this area, then what will happen is this area is removed while you are removing this also, is removed while you are removing this also, and was removed while you are removing this also. Is it all right? So it is removed three times, but it should be removed only two times. So this P and that area is exactly A intersection B intersection C, should be added once more, is it right? Once you add this area one more time, this area was totally excluded because it was excluded over here also and over here also. Now it should be included one. So if you add this, you will be getting an answer of PA intersection B, A union B union C, if two events are not mutually exclusive. So if we summarize, if two events are mutually exclusive, PA union B is PA intersection B, sorry, PA plus PB, PA union B union C, if the events are mutually exclusive, is PA plus PB plus PC. If they are not mutually exclusive, means there is some intersection, then PA union B is PA plus PB minus PA intersection B, and for three events it is PA plus PB plus PC minus PA intersection B minus PB intersection C minus PA intersection C plus PA intersection B intersection C. We are going to learn something regarding independent event and mutually exclusive event. Now, what is mutually exclusive event? First try to understand it. This is a space, this is event A, event B. In any case, when A intersection B is null set or there is no A intersection B, the event are mutually exclusive event. Now, what does this mean? That A and B cannot happen simultaneously. So this is mutually exclusive event. Let us take an experiment of tossing a coin. Is it mutually exclusive? Yes, either head can come or tail can come. Is it possible that in one coin toss we will be getting head and tail? The answer is no, it is impossible. So this type of events are mutually exclusive. Is it alright? Now let us go to independent event. Independent event, let me draw a Venn diagram itself. Space. Sir, there is an intersection. Yes, there can be intersection in independent event. This is event A, this is event B. Is it alright? When the event are independent event, try to understand, is it alright? Mr. A is hitting a target, so there is a gun and they both are hitting a target, and what is the probability of A that Mr. A is hitting a target, is it alright? What is probability of B is Mr. B is hitting a target. Can there be intersection, this portion? The answer is yes. So what is this intersection portion? What is this intersection portion is? A and B both are hitting target. So this portion is an intersection where A and B both are hitting the target. Now the question is A hitting a target and B hitting a target are related or not related? They are not related. If they are not related, they will be independent events. Sir, can there be a chart of this type where there is an intersection where the events are independent event? The answer is yes. Is it alright? And whenever they are independent event, try to understand P A intersection B is equal to P A into P B. Mr. A hitting the target and is multiplication. Mr. B hitting the target. Is it alright? But this can be used only if event are independent. Is it alright? So one more formula in our formula box. Whenever the events are independent, P A intersection B is equal to P A into P B. And this formula cannot be used for mutually exclusive, and ultimately mutually exclusive P A intersection B is nothing but null set. This was independent and mutually exclusive. We are going to learn some of the Venn diagrams in probability. So, in probability, first, let us understand A dash. Now, if this is a sample space, and this is event A, what is A dash basically means? Anything except A. So, what is anything except A is this. and this area will be termed as A dash. Is it all right? This area will be termed as A dash. Anything except A. Is it all? So B dash can easily be termed out. Is it all right? Let us do another point, which is A minus B. So this is event A, this is event B, is it correct? Let us do A minus B. So what is event A? Can you tell me? Will this area be regarded as event A? The answer is yes, is it correct? So this is a full A, is it correct? Now, what is A minus B is, from this area which is selected, remove any portion which is also included in B. So which portion is included in B is this portion. If it is this portion, it is nothing but A intersection B. So this portion should be removed. Let me remove this portion. So this area will be termed as A minus B. This area will be termed as A minus B. Let me also try out B minus A. This is A, this is B. Is that all right? Let me first draw B area. Is this area included in B? Yes. So this is a B area. Remove any portion of this area which is also included in A. So this portion A intersection B is included in A. Let me remove that. This area will be treated as B minus A. Is it correct? Let us play with this all jargons. Is it correct? Let us do simple A intersection B. This is A, this is B, where A and B merges. This is A intersection B, is it correct? A union B. A union B. This is nothing but A union B. Is it correct? Let me do another A intersection B dash. Sorry. Now, what I do is I always take it with different colors. Sorry. So, let me do this with white itself. Is it all? A, first I am tick marking A. B dash. Now I am tick marking anything. What is B dash? Anything except B. This is B dash. You collect. You need to find out intersection. Let me do where it intersects with yellow color. Is it right? Where this intersects exactly in this portion, this yellow color portion. Is it all right? So this yellow color portion is nothing but A minus B. Is it all right? So A intersection B dash is nothing but A minus B. Now you don't need to learn this all formulas. Do it every time by drawing a Venn diagram logically. Is it all right? Let me do B union A dash. B union A dash. Is it all right? Let me draw a diagram. Let me draw with different colors. First B. This is B. Union A dash. Anything but A. This is A dash. And why I am not using different color, I tell you.
This is A dash.
Now, all the portions which are tick marked, because we want to find out union and not intersection, all the portion which is ticked out, so except this portion, everything is nothing but a B union A dash. Is it all right? So this the scratch portion is removed, otherwise each and every portion is nothing but B union A dash. Now logically, whatever type of jargons are given, you can always draw a Venn diagram, find out the probability. Is it all right? Now someone will say, sir, this all are theoretical and not practical. Let me explain this particular idea in probability in practical life. Is it right? See, Mr. A hitting a target is a probability of A, and Mr. B hitting a target is a probability of B. Now, if someone wants to find out, say in there is a tournament where in finals, if B hits the target, and if A hits the target, it will be a draw. If B hits the target and A does not hit the target, B will win. Is it alright? So you want to find out B winning. So what probability, what do you want to find out? That B is hitting the target and A is not hitting the target. Necessarily, sorry. Then I am actually find out a probability of this particular area. Is it all right? So this in practical life is also useful. Will be determined at different stage in situation. Different charts might be used just to find out the probability. There are three persons, A, B and C, having different ages. The probability that A survives, I'm just writing PA. Probability that A survives for another 5 years is 0.80. Probability that B survives, the probability of B surviving is 0.16. C survives is 0.50. Probability that C survives is 0.50. The probability that A and B survives, PA intersection B, is 0.46. P, B and C survives, B intersection C is 0.32. A and C survives, A intersection C is 0.48. The probability that all these three persons survives, PA intersection B intersection C, will be given by 0.26. We need to find the probability that at least one of them survives. At least one of them survives is either A survives or B survives or C survives. Whenever it is or, I need to find out PA union B union C. I will be using the formula PA plus PB plus PC plus PA minus this is minus PA intersection B minus PB intersection C minus P A intersection C plus, as it is reduced for more time, one time we need to add it, P A intersection B intersection C, that particular area. P A is 0.80 plus P B is 0.60 plus P C is 0.50 minus 0.46 minus 0.32 minus 0.48 plus 0.26, we will be getting answer of 0.90. So either of them survives, the probability is given by 0.90. Let us solve some of the questions of probability. This question is, three events A, B and C are mutually exclusive. So understand, first let me draw with the help of Venn diagram. These are event A, B and C, is it all right? In the sample space, why there is no intersection? Because they are mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive basically means there is no intersection between any of the events. They are exhaustive. What does it mean? There are no other outcomes other than A, B and C. So this space, even if it is drawn, it is null, is it all right? There's no event over here except A, B and C, is it all right? So what does mutually exclusive means? A intersection B is null set, B intersection C is null set, and A intersection C is null set, is it all right? What does exhaustive means? Understand, P A plus P B plus P C is equal to 1. 1 is certainty. So either A will happen or B will happen or C will happen. This basically means they are exhausted. That's right. And equally likely, what is equally likely event is PA is equal to PB is equal to PC. Is it all right? This is nothing but equally likely. Equally likely basically means the probability of all the events is equal, is it alright? So this is equally likely, is it alright? What is the probability of complementary event of A? So what they are asking is P A dash, and we will be understanding how to find out P A dash. So continuing with our previous example, in this example we need to find out A dash, is it alright? What is the probability of the complementary event of A? Is it alright? Now we have understood that PA plus PB plus PC is equal to 1. Is it alright? We have also, because they are exhaustive, they are equally likely. So PA plus PB, sorry, PA is equal to PB is equal to PC. Is it alright? So instead of PB, I can write down PA. Yes, I can write down, instead of PC also I can write down PA. Yes, is equal to 1. So 3PA is equal to 1. So probability of A is 1. Is it alright? If probability of A is 1/3, see, total probability is 1. If P of A is 1/3, then P of A dash will be 1, that is total probability, minus 1/3, that is nothing but 2/3. Sir, how you have found out this? P A dash is 1 minus 1/3. Understand. Suppose this is A and this probability is 1/3. Total probability of sample space will be 1. Is it all? What I want to find out A dash. So if this total is 1, this area is 1/3, this area will be 1 minus 1/3, which will be nothing but 2/3. This was example number 16.8. Let us go to another example. This will be doing inside. 16.9. A number is selected from first 25 natural numbers first 25 natural numbers. So what is the sample space is 1, 2, 3 up till 25. What is the probability that it would be divisible by 4 or 7? Is it all right? So find out number of events which is divisible by 4. Is it all right? So which are the numbers is 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24. What are number of events which are divisible by 7? It is 7, 14, 21. Those are three numbers divisible by 7. Let me draw a Venn diagram for this question. Sorry. This is A. This is B. Sir, why you have not drawn intersection? See the numbers. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 7, 14, 21. No figures are common in this sample space and this space. Is it all right? So I have drawn it separately. This is A. This is B. What is A? Number is divisible by 4. What is B? Number is divisible by 7. Is it all right? So we need to find out what? Probability of A or B plus B union B. A union B. I want to find out this area. So now there is no, they are mutually exclusive event, then PA union B is nothing but PA plus P. What is the probability that the number is divisible by 4? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 divided by 25. M upon N. This is 3 divided by 25. The probability that the number is either divisible by 4 or 7 is 6 by 25 plus 3 by 25 is nothing but 9 by 25. This is the answer of this particular probability. Now, if the question was, what is the probability that number is divisible by, in same question, is divisible by 4 and 7. What we need to find out, PA intersection B, which is nothing but null set. There is no PA intersection B. So there is no number which is divisible by 4 and 7. But 4 or 7? 4 and 7. This is or, this is and. Or is union, and is intersection. Or is addition, and is multiplication. Stop. This is question number 16.10. A coin is tossed thrice. What is the probability of getting two or more heads? Now understand, this problem can be solved by Venn diagram, but it is not necessary to always solve it by Venn diagram. And in this case also, I will not be solving it by Venn diagram. Is it all right? I want two or more heads if the coin is tossed thrice. If the coin is tossed thrice, what are the different outcomes? N. What are the different outcomes? Is it all right? Head, head, head. Three times head. Now two times head. Head, head, tail. Head, tail, head, tail, head, head. Now one time head. Head, tail, 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 head, tail, 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 head. Now zero times head. So that is tail, tail, tail. So how many number of outcomes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This can be found out by, the experiment was having two outcomes. It is repeated three times, which is nothing but 8. What is the probability of getting two or more heads? In which case there are two or more heads? In this case, yes. In this case, yes. 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 No. No. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 cases when there are 2 or more heads. Here there are 2 heads. Here there is 3 heads. So 2 or more heads. So M will be is equal to 4. Probability will be probability of getting 2 or more heads is given by M upon N, that is 4 upon 8, that is half. 0.50. This is an interesting question. The number is selected at random from 1000 natural numbers. Is it all right? So, how many natural numbers are there? 1000. So 1, 2, 3 up till 1000. Now, what is the probability that it would be multiple of 5? So probability of A is given by it is multiple of 5. How many numbers will be multiple of 5? I'll tell you an idea. Is it alright? Say if there are 10 natural numbers, how many of them will be multiple of 5 is 2 natural numbers, 5 and 10? Is it alright? How it can be done is 10 divided by 5. That is nothing but 2. So here there are 1000 natural numbers. Is it alright? Divided by 5. It is 200. So it will be 200. Divided by 1000. The probability that number is divisible by 5. Probability that the number is divisible by 9. Same manner. B. How many numbers will be divisible by 9? Will be 1000 divided by 9. Is it all? Do it in your calculator. 1000 divided by 9. Now what is the answer? See it properly. It is 111.11. Now that 0.11 should be ignored. It is 111 divided by 1000. But here the events are not mutually exclusive. There will be events of P A intersection B. Is it all right? Now what is P A intersection B? Understand. P A intersection B is the number is a multiple by 5 and 9. So it should be multiple of 45. How many number of events? 1000 divided by 45. Ignore the decimals. 1000 divided by 45 is 22.22. I will be writing only this 22 will be ignored. The probability of A intersection B is 22 divided by 1000. Let us see what we need to find out. The probability that it would be multiple of 5 or 9. Is it what we need to find out? Probability of A union B. If I want to find out probability of A union B, it will be PA plus PB minus PA intersection B. This we have done. So PA is 200 divided by 1000 plus PB 111 divided by 1000 minus 22 divided by 1000. The answer will be 200 plus 111 minus 22, that is 289 divided by 1000. This will be the probability. Now this question is good for understanding the logic also. What is the logic? Try to understand. Why we deduct this A minus PA intersection B or PA minus B? Is it alright? A intersection B while finding out PA union B. There will be 200 numbers which are divisible by 5. There will be 111 numbers which are divisible by 9. But there will be 22 numbers which are divisible by 5 also and 9 also. So it is included in this. It should be included, yes, but one time. It is included in this also, it is included in this also. The number which are divisible by 9 and 5 both, that is there, it is multiple of 45. So it is removed one time. Because it is included in both this numerator, it is reduced one. I will be getting a correct answer of probability. This is question number 16.2. The probability that an accountant's job applicant has a BCom degree. So let us have an event A, which says an applicant has a BCom degree. Is it all? And B, that he has a CA degree. Now, the accountant job applicant has a BCom degree is 0.85. So I can write down PA is equal to 0.85. PB is equal to 0.30. And he is both BCom and CA. BCom and CA. PA is 0.25. Out of 500 applicants, this will be doing afterwards. How many would be having BCom or CA degree? Probability of BCom or CA degree is given by PA, union or intersection, it is union. B, either A or B. So if he is A, then also it is alright. B, then also it is alright. A or B, then also it is alright. First, let me find out the probability. You know the formula, PA plus PB minus PA intersection B, which is 0.85 plus 0.30. minus 0.25. Is it all? So 0.85 plus 0.3 minus 0.25 gives me 0.90. Is it all? Now, in next point, we are going to learn expected value. So, but we will not be again going back to this example. So, let me do it. What is an expected value? Is number of applicants. So, there are 500 number of applicants multiplied by probability. So what are the number of people having BCom or CA degree will be 500 into 9, that is 450 people or applicants. Sorry. So sir, this logically is not understood, but we'll be doing when we start with expected value. Sorry. This 16.13, if PA minus B is 1/5. Let me draw all the diagrams and this is my Venn diagram where there is a PA and there is PB. So what is this A minus B? Let me denote it all by different colors. This is exactly PA minus B is 1/5, is it wrong? PA is 1/3. So this area full is PA is 1/3. PB is half. So B is green color area. PB is half. Now they are not exhaustive, it's not given they are exhaustive, so we cannot directly do this total area as 1 and remove this half and A minus B will be half. We cannot do it, is it correct? So these are the different probabilities which are given. What is the probability that out of two events A and B, only B would incur? So what I want to find out, probability of B? No, it is probability of B happening without any condition minus A. Only B should happen, A should not happen. Is it alright? So let me find out, try to find out the probability. Is it alright? I want to exactly find out the probability of this area. In same Venn diagram, this is A, this is B, and I want answer of exactly this area. Can I say it is nothing but PB minus PA intersection B? PB is available or not available? Available, half. Minus PA intersection B. I need to find out, is it all? So, what is this yellow area? 1/5. What is this blue area? Is 1/3. Is it all right? So, can I say 1/3 blue area? Try to concentrate on this diagram. From this blue area, if I remove A intersection B, so blue area is 1/3. If I remove A intersection B, I will be getting answer of A minus B, which is nothing but 1/5. Stop. Yes. So PA intersection B is 1/3 minus 1/5 will be PA intersection B. Once again, 1/3 is blue area. I am removing A intersection B, I get 1/5. This will be 5 minus 3 upon 15 will be PA intersection. This is 2 upon 15, Ezra. So this will be 2 upon 15. Ezra, we have proved PA intersection B is equal to 2 upon 15. Is it all? So this will be 15 minus 4 upon 30 will be 11 upon 30. Ezra, let me verify my answer is correct. Yes, this is the correct answer. This is probability of B minus A, or probability that only B will occur. Stop. This is 11 divided by 30. Hello friends, we are going to learn something regarding conditional probability. So in an experiment there are two events, and if I want to find out a probability that event A will happen, now, if this is the only statement, it is nothing but PA, but we are right now not talking about PA. Probability that event A will happen, given that B has already happened, then this in technical language is denoted by probability of event A, given that B has already happened, and is given by formula probability of A intersection B divided by, which has already happened, PB. A nothing but PB. Sir, where this formula came? This will be understanding. Where this formula came, how it is used, how this concept is used. But right now try to understand this formula, and just try to understand that this probability that can be found out by this particular formula. Now understand, so let us understand this full formula in form of an example. Start. We are still continuing with conditional probability. Let us take an experiment. So what is an experiment? Throwing a dice twice. So a dice is thrown, or two dice are thrown simultaneously. Is it all? What are the different outcomes if two dice are thrown? Let us see the outcomes. One, two. Sorry. We should start with 1, 1. 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7. 1, 7 is not possible. Second is 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6, 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6. In examination, this is not required. I have drawn this just to understand this particular idea of conditional probability logically. Sorry. Try to understand, I am defining event A. Event A is total of both the dies is 10. Sorry. Let me find out the probability of A also. So how many total outcomes are there? 36. We have found out. Is it alright? These are total 36. Is it alright? What are the favorable events? Event A is that total on the two dice is 10. Let me tick mark the event total on the two dice is 10. We'll start from here. 1, 2, 3. These are the three cases where total is 10. Is it all right? Yes. These are the three cases where total is 10. Is it all right? So what is the probability is? 3 by 36. Is it all right? That is, event A has happened. The probability is 3 by 36. Understand event B. One of the dice is showing 4. One of the dies is showing a figure 4. Let me find out probability of B without any condition. Probability of B. Is it right? In which all cases the dice are showing 4? One of the dies is showing 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11. So there are 11 cases where one of the dice is showing 4. 11 divided by 36. Now, if someone asks me this, what is the probability that dice is showing 4 given that total is 10. Understand technically how I'll write it down. Probability of dice showing 4. One of the dice is showing 4. This is one of the dice. One of the dice is showing 4. Given that total is 10. Is it alright? So probability of B, given that A has already happened, will be given by P A intersection B divided by P A. What is first P A intersection B? Let us find out. Is it all right? How many events are having both the conditions satisfied? That is, total is 10 and one of the dice is showing 4. 1 and 2. I'm marking it by yellow. This two events, right? This is 1. This is 2. These are the two events whereby, so P A intersection B will be 2 by 36. Total is 10 and one of the dice is showing 4. Is it alright? So P A intersection B is a 2 by 36 divided by P A. What is P A is 3 by 36. And the answer will be 2 divided by 3. This is my answer of conditional probability. The answer is yes. Now understand. Sir, how this is logically true? You have not explained this formula, how this is logically true. Let us not understand any formula except I am opponent. First tell me which event has already happened. Probability that dice is showing 4. Given that the total is 4. So already the dice is showing, two dice are showing total 4. Is it alright? So in which case it is possible when the dice are showing total 4, 6, 4. So let us take, say, you are understanding this logically. See, what we want to find out? Probability that one of the dice is showing 4. Given that the total is 10, is it all? So given that the total is 10 has already happened, so in which case the total can be 10? In three cases, 4, 6, 5, 5, 6, 4. So let us redefine an experiment. Suppose this is a sample space. What is the probability that one of the dice is showing 4. This experiment has already happened. This is not our sample space. This is not our total number of outcomes. These are our total number of outcomes. So n will be 3. How many of in how many cases one of the dice is showing 4? 1 and 2. So m will be favorable outcomes, that is 2. Probability of an event will be given by m upon n, which is nothing but 2 upon 3. And these two answers are absolutely same. So, conditional probability, if found out with this formula or found out in a normal general circumstances, one event has already happened. Take outcomes of only that event and then do favorable outcomes, the answer is remaining same. We logically summarize the formula. Probability of A slash B is P A intersection B divided by P B. And PB slash A is PA intersection B divided by PA. It is very difficult to forget denominator. Is it alright? The reason is, if this is B, this will be B. If this is A, this will be A. Is it alright? And this can be easily found out. Let us continue with our questions. Rupesh is known to hit a target in 5 out of 9 shots. Probability that Rupesh will hit the target is given by 5 upon 9. David is known to hit the same target in 6 out of 11 shots. So probability that David will hit the target is 6 divided by 11. What is the probability that target would be hit once they both try? Probability of target is hit. Now, when there is a success in this type of probability, try to understand. Number one, when Rupesh hits, or when David hits, or Rupesh and David hits. Technically, I can find out by P R union D. P R union D. Is it alright? And let me do it first by Venn diagram. Try to understand. This is Rupesh hitting the target. This is David hitting the target. This should not be.
This is Rupesh hitting the target. This is David hitting the target. Is it all? So, what we need to find out, target is hit either by Rupesh or by both or by David. So, try to understand what I am finding out. I am finding out this area first. Now, we all know total probability is 1. If we get probability of this blue area, then 1 minus that blue area is nothing but this area. Is it all right? So, what is probability of blue area? Probability of blue area is Ramesh and David does not hit the target. How does this possible understand? What is the probability that Ramesh does not hit the target is 5 by 9? What is the probability that David also does not hit the target and multiplication? They both are independent event. Is it all right? So, what is the probability that Ramesh does not hit the target is not 5 by 9? This is incorrect. It is 4 by 9. What is the probability that Ramesh will hit the target is 5 by 9? So, not hit the target will be 4 by 9. David will hit the target is 6 by 11. So, not hit the target will be 5 by 11. So, this is a probability that neither Ramesh nor D and D will not hit the target. Is it all right? It is 20 divided by 99. Is it all right? Now, what I want to find out actually is this white area. Is it all right? So, what is that white area? Total probability is 1 minus what is the blue area probability out of total probability 1? If I remove this blue area, I will be getting white area minus 20 divided by 99. This is 79 divided by 99. This is a probability that target will be hit exactly this area. Is it all right? This white color area in this Venn diagram represents this probability. What is this 20 divided by 9? The probability that target will not be hit neither by R and nor by D. Is it all right? This is a probability that target will be hit either by R or by D or by R and D. Now this question we have already done, but let us again revise it. And I'll tell you how to solve it in the next one. A pair of dice is thrown together and the sum of the points of two dice is noted to be 10. So this experiment is already done. Is it all right? How it can be 10? 4, 6, 6, 4 and 5, 5. So this experiment is already done. No need to find out the probability. What is the probability that one of the two dice has shown the point 4. So, what is total number of outcome is 3 because this experiment is already finished. What is the probability that one of the dice shows the point 4? Shows the point 4. There are two outcomes. So, favorable outcomes. So, it is 2. Probability that one of the dice will be showing 4 given that this event has already happened is given by M upon N, that is nothing but 2 by 3. Next question, an interesting question. In a group of 20 males and 15 females, 12 males are service holder. So, what is the probability? What is the probability that a man is a service holder is given by 12 males are a service holder out of 20? What is the probability that female is a service holder is 8 divided by 15. Our service holder. What is the probability that a person selected at random from the group is a service holder given that a selected person is a male? So now what normally people does is people try to find out conditional probability without seeing the question. Yes, this can be found out by conditional probability, but try to understand. A better idea is to find out normally. Is it all right? What is the probability that a person selected at random from the group is a service holder? So this probability I need to find out. Probability that a person is service holder. What event has already happened? Given that the selected person is male, so now I will be taking sample space of only male. How many number of males are there is 20. How many people are service holder from that 20? 12. So male service holder will be success, M will be 12. So person is service holder, given that he is male, is given by 12 by 20, which is nothing but 2 6s are 12, 2 10s are 20, 2 3s are 6, 2 5s are 10, this is 0.6. So even if females information was not given, then also the answer would be same. It is useless to find out this type of question by conditional probability. You can normally find out answer of this type of questions. Let us go to next question. In the connection with random experiment, it is found that PA is 2 by 3. So PA is 2 by 3. PB is 3 by 5. PA union B is 5 by 6. Evaluate the following probabilities. So first, let me find out PA intersection B because it might be useful sometimes. Is it all right? So PA union B is equal to PA plus PB minus PA intersection B. PA union B is given by 5 by 6 is equal to PA is 2 by 3 plus PB is 3 by 5 minus PA intersection B. PA intersection B coming on this side, it is a 2 by 3 plus 3 by 5 minus 5 by 6. So this is 5 2s are 10, 3 3s are 9, 19 divided by 15 minus 5 divided by 6. So 3 5 6 5 into 10 30. So this is 19 2s are 36, 36, 6 5s are 30 minus 25 divided by 30. So this is 11 divided by 30 is nothing but minus, right? This is 5 2s are 10, 3 3s are 9, 19 divided by 15 minus 5 by 6, minus 5 by 6. So 30 is an LCM, 15 2s are 30, 19 2s are 38, minus 25. So it is 13 divided by 30. Is it all right? So A intersection B is 13 divided by 30. Let us find out what we need to find out. Evaluate P A given that B has already happened. This is our question number one. So it is nothing but P A intersection B divided by what has already happened, PB. PA intersection B is 13 divided by 30 and PB is 3 divided by 5 6 are 30, 13 3s are 39 divided by 5 6 are 30. So it is 13 divided by 6, 13 divided by 6 divided by 3, just divided by 3, so multiplied by 1 upon 3, yes, it is 13 divided by PB slash A. Second, PB slash A will be given by PA intersection B divided by PB. PA intersection B is 13 by 30 divided by PB will be, PA will be 2 upon 3. 3 tens are 30, it is 13 divided by 20. PA dash B, and this is good. I want to find out PA dash slash B. It is nothing but PA dash intersection B upon PB. Now, PD I am knowing, is it all right? I am finding out A dash intersection B. Try to understand in this Venn diagram. A dash intersection B. What is A dash? Is this area? This is A dash intersection B. Let me draw B with blue color. Where it intersects, it is nothing but PB minus A. PB minus A, that is PB other than when A happens. This is nothing but this is where white and blue color intersects. Is it all right? So this is given by PB minus PA intersection B. So what is PB is 3 by 5. PA intersection B is given by 13 by 30. So this is 18 minus 13. 5 divided by 30. Is it all? That is nothing but PA dash intersection B is 5 by 30. Divided by PB is 3 by 5. This is 5, 6 are 30. It is 5 divided by 18. Next, PA intersection PA slash B dash. Now, I need to find out PA intersection B dash. Believe me, it will be P. A intersection B dash will be A minus B. A minus B will be P A. It is 2 by 3 minus P A intersection B is 13 by 30. So this is 20. This is 7 divided by 30. Divided by P B dash. So PA intersection B dash is given by 7 by 30 divided by PB dash. It is not PB. PB dash will be 2 by 5. If PB is 3 by 5, P dash will be 2 by 5. This is 5, 6 are 30. 7 divided by will be nothing but 4th answer. 5th answer. PA dash slash B dash. Let me add up some of the portion. Even in the Venn diagram, I am rubbing it down. I will be. So, what I want to find out? It is a P. If this is 5th one. P A dash slash B dash. How it will be found out is P A dash intersection B dash divided by P B dash. P D B dash we are knowing, it is 2 by 5, is it all right? But we don't know A dash intersection B dash. Draw anything except A. There is anything except A. With blue color, I am drawing anything except B.
where it intersects other than A union B. Is it all right? So it is 1 minus P A union B. What is A union B? Is 5 by 6. So 1 minus 5 by 6 will be nothing but intersection of A dash and B dash, which is nothing but 1 by 6. Is it all right? So P A dash and intersection B dash is nothing but 1 by 6. And PB dash is nothing but B dash we have found out. It is 2 by 5. Answer will be 1 upon 6 multiplied by 5 upon 2. That is nothing but 5 upon 12. This is how we find out A dash intersection B dash. This is 16.19. The odds in favor of an event is 2 by 3. Now, this is the first time we are learning odds. Odds in favor of event is 2 is to 3. Try to understand what does this mean. 2 times it is favorable when 3 times it is not favorable. 2 times you will win and 3 times you will lose. 2 times you will hit the target and 3 times you will not hit the target. So what will be the total outcomes is 5. What is a success is a 2 by 5. What is failure will be 3 by 5. Odds in favor. So favorable will be 2. Non-favorable will be 3. Total will be 5. So probability that A event will happen will be given by 2 by 3? No, 2 by 5. This is known as odds. Odds against another event. Against another event is 3 is to 7. What does it mean? 3 times you will lose and 7 times you will win. It is against and not in favor as in this case. Is it alright? So, what is the probability of B event? Probability of winning, probability of success is 7. Out of 3? No. Out of total, that is 10. What they are asking? Find out the probability that only one of the two events will occur. See, many of the times the students say this. Sir, either A or B or A and B happens. No, this is not what they are asking. Read the question carefully. Find the probability that only one of the two event occurs. So what probability they are asking is very interesting. They are asking only this probability. Sir, can I do PA union B minus one more time PA intersection B? One more time means in PA union B there is already A intersection B subtracted. So one more time PA intersection B, the answer is yes. Or, sir, we can find out this PA minus B plus PB minus A. Yes, in both the ways the answer is correct answer. Alright. Are they independent event? Yes, this event and this event are totally independent. They are not related to each other. Are they mutually exclusive? No, because there is an intersection that these two events may happen simultaneously. But are they independent event? The answer is yes. So if there is an independent event, PA intersection B will be is equal to 2 by 5 multiplied by 7 by 10. So, this will be 14 by 15. Now, what is PA? Is 2 by 5. What is PB? 7 by 10. If I do minus 14 by 50, if I do minus 14 by 50, I will be getting PA union B. Is it all right?
but I want to remove this portion also. So I'll be subtracting one more time. Minus 14 by 15. Are you getting it? Is it alright? So, whatever is this answer, is it alright? This is also PA minus PA intersection B will give me answer of PA minus B. PB minus PA intersection B will be giving me answer of PB minus A. Is it alright? We can take an LCM and directly find out the answer. LCM, let's take it 50. So this will be 20 plus 14 minus 28 divided by 50. Answer will be 34 minus 28, 6 divided by 50 will be my answer. This is incorrect. This is multiplied by 5. This is multiplied by 10. So 7 multiplied by 5. This is 35. So we are not getting the answer. 55 minus 28 is 27. So this is 27 divided by 50 is a correct answer. So what is correct is 27 divided by. This is nothing but question number 16.19. This is also somewhat interesting question. There are three boxes with following composition. So let us understand the boxes. There are blue, there is box 1, box 2, box 3. There is blue, red and white boxes. In box 1 there are 5 blue, 8 red and 10 white balls. Total 23 balls. Now what experiment you are doing? One ball is drawn from each box. What is the probability that they would be of same color? Now understand. Let us first assume that you select the first box. Now selecting a box is not an experiment, right? You are drawing a ball from each box. The probability that from first box the ball will be blue is given by five divided by 23, because there are five blue balls of total 23 balls, and in the second end is multiplication. In second back box also the ball selected is blue, is 4 by 21, and in third box also the ball is blue, is 3 by 16. Or in first box red ball is selected, what is the probability? 8 by 23. In second box red is selected, what is the probability? Is 9 by 21. In third box red is selected, what is the probability? Is 6 by 16 again. Or in first box selected the ball is white is given by 10 by 23 and 8 by 21. Third box the selected ball is white is 7 by 16. If you find out total answer of this, this is 1052 divided by 7728. This was an interesting question because you did not select the box that we are doing 16.26 for, so that these two questions can be compared. There are three boxes with the following composition. So these are the boxes with compositions. There are three boxes with the following number. Box 1, 7 red, 5 white, 4 blue. 4 blue. Box 2, 5 red, 6 white, 3 blues. Box 3, 4 red, 3 whites, 2 blue. Is it all right? Let me write on the total over here. 7 plus 5, 12 plus 4, 16 balls, 11 plus 3, 14 balls, 7 plus 2, 9 balls. Is it all right? What they are asking? One of the box is selected at random. Try to understand, it is different from the previous question. One of the box is selected at random and then a ball is drawn from it. Is it all right? So first, what is the probability that box 1 is selected? Is 1 by 3. And what is the probability that a ball drawn is red? Is 7 by 16, because there are 7 red balls and total balls are 16. Or what is the probability that box 2 is selected? Is 1 by 3. What is the probability that a selected ball is red? Is 5 by 14. What is the probability that box 3 is selected? 1 by 3. What is the probability that a selected ball is red? Is 4 by 9. So if someone of you have done this, 7 divided by 16 into 5 divided by 14 into 4 divided by 9. Is it all right? Then you should understand this is not a correct answer. Why it is not a correct answer? Because ultimately you need to first select one box and then a ball is drawn at random. So first a box will be selected, then a ball will be drawn at random. Is it all right? So this will be ultimately this can be found out in this manner. 1 by 3, 7 upon 16 plus 5 upon 14 plus 4 upon 9 will give you the same answer. Is it all right? What is this? A box is selected. How one box can be selected? 1 divided by 3. What is the probability that a ball selected from box 1 will be red? 7 by 16 or 5 by 14 or 4 by 9. This will be the correct answer. Let me write down the correct answer. It is 1, 2, 4, 9. Divided by 3024. I am directly seeing it from book. You can calculate and just write down the answer. This is also an interesting question. Mr. Roy is selected for three separate posts. For the first post, there are three candidates. So probability that Roy will be selected in first post is 1 by 3. Try to understand, if there are 3 people and if there is equal chances that each person will be selected, then my chance of selection is 1 by 3 because there are total 3 people and 1 is success, 2 is failure. For the second post, so probability that Roy will be selected for second post, there are 5 candidates, so it is 1 by 5. And probability that Roy will be selected for third post, there are 10 candidates, so it is 1 by 10. What is the probability that Mr. Roy would be selected? Mr. Roy would be selected. See, many of them finds out probability in this manner. Roy selected in first post, or Roy selected in second post, or Roy selected in third post. And they do addition of this 3, and which is not correct. Understand? This is a vast sentence and it includes n numbers of possibilities. Mr. Roy would be selected. So you need to also take possibility Roy selected in first post and Roy selected in second post, or Roy selected in first post and Roy selected in third post, or Roy selected in second post and Roy selected in third post, or Roy selected in first plus Roy selected in second plus Roy selected in third post. Now, this is difficult to find out all the situation and you add it. It is difficult to find out. There is an easy way. If you think, stop the video and try to think about it, how to solve it. See, what I will do? I will find out a different type of probability. What is the probability? What is the probability that Roy is not selected? Now it is easy to find out why. It includes only one situation. Roy is not selected on first post, and Roy is not selected in second post, and Roy is not selected in third post. If I find out this, it includes each and every possibility. Roy is not selected means he is not selected in 1 or 2 or 3 or in all of them. As it is and, I have drawn multiplication. What is the probability that Roy is not selected in first post is not 1 by 3. Roy not selected in first post is given by 2 by 3. Not selected in second post is given by 4 by 5. And not selected in third post is given by 9 by 10. So let me first find out this probability. It is 2 by 3 multiplied by 4 by 5 multiplied by 9 by 10. So this will be ultimately 3 threes are 9, 2 fives are 10. This is 12 upon 20. So what is the probability that Roy is not selected? We all know total probability is 1. What is the probability that he will be selected is 1 minus probability that he is not selected. So this will include 1 minus 12 upon 20. 5, this is 25 minus 12 is 13 upon 25. So this will include all these cases. It will not include only one case where he is not selected in all three posts. So instead of finding out this white color answer, you should find out this red color answer. You know that total probability is 1. 1 minus this red color answer, you will be getting the probability that Mr. Roy is selected. There is one more question, 16.22. The independent probability that three sections of costing department will encounter a computer error. So, probability that in department 1 there will be an error is given by 0.2. Probability that in department 2 there will be error is given by 0.3, and the probability that department 3 will be having an error is given by 0.1. What is the probability that there would be at least one computer error per week? Now, at least one computer error. Believe me, it is not as simple as A union B union C, because it should include A intersection B intersection it is A union B union C, is that alright? So either it can be in one department, in other department, or in third department, is that alright? So probability of at least one computer error can be given by probability that none of a department is having computer error. I will tell you how it goes. Is it all right? Computer error. There are three departments, so there can be computer error in zero departments, there can be computer error in one department, there can be computer error in two departments, there can be computer error in three departments. What we need to find out is probability of all these three. What we are finding out is probability of this. Probability that none of the department will be having a computer error will be given by probability that first department is not having computer error is given by 0.8. Sir, 0.2. No, it is having computer error. We are finding out not having computer error. And not having computer error in department 2 and not having computer error in department 3. This will be given by 0.8 into 0.7 into 0.9 is given by 0.504. What we want to find out? At least one. Now, if you are knowing probability of this is 0.504, total probability is 1. What is the probability of this? 1 minus 504, it is 0.496. So at least one computer error includes 1 error, 2 error and 3 error, and the probability is 0.496. Probability that there would be one and only one computer error per week. Is it all right? All right. So, one and only one. So, how it is possible? Say, this is the first costing department, this is second costing department, this is third costing department. Is it all right? So, how it is possible? If first department is having computer error, second department is not having computer error, and third department is not having computer error. Or, so in first department there was computer error, right? Or in first department there is no computer error, and in second department there is a computer error. Second department there is a computer error, and in third department there is no computer error. Or in first department there is no computer error, in second department computer error, this is 0.3. In second department there is no computer error, and in third department there is a computer error. So it will be 0.2 into 0.7 into 0.9 plus 0.8 into 0.3 into 0.9 plus 0.8 into 0.7 into 0.1 will give me answer of probability. Now I'm not calculating this, but answer is 0.40. Is it all right? This is a good sum of computer error. This is 16.23. A lot of 10 electronic component is known to include 3 defective parts. Is it all right? So how many are defective is 3 out of 10. So non-defective is 7, total is 10. A sample of 4 components is selected at random. So what are total number of combination is 10C4. Is it all? There are total 10 outcomes out of which 4 are selected. What is the probability that this sample does not contain more than one defective? It is not detectives, it is more than one detectives. So probabilities that there are 0 detectives and probability that there are 0 defectives or probability that there is one defective, not more than one. So one is a success. So what is the probability that there will be 0 defective? So you have selected from 4, you have selected 4, is it all right? From 4, 0 is defective. from defective. So out of 4, C, there are 3 defectives. I will be selecting 0 out of it. There are 7 non-defectives. I will be selecting 4 out of it. Or 1 defective. There are 3 defective. I will be selecting 1 out of it. And there are 7 non-defective and I will be selecting 3 out of it. So the probability that there is 0 defective or probability that there is 1 defective is given by 3C0 multiplied by 7C4 plus 3C1 multiplied by 7C3. Again, I am not finding out the answer after doing permutation and combination. This will be extremely easy. This will be divided by n. This is n. N is 10C4. And if you divide, if you find out the answer, your answer will be 2/3.